Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 3.3, Problem 9. This is Section 3.3, Problem number 9. It says, for the two box plots shown below, answer the following questions. A is which one has the largest value? Well, the line coming out of the top of the box plot goes to the larger value, and according to the number scale, box plot number 1 has the largest value of 100, and box plot number 2 has the largest value of about 120. So box plot number 2 has the largest data value. Which one has the smallest data value? Now, the line coming out of the bottom of the box on your box plot goes to the smallest data value. And if you look on box plot number 1, it looks like it comes fairly close to the 0. And for box plot number 2, it goes pretty close to the 20, maybe a tiny bit below. So the smaller data value is in box plot number 1. And which one has the largest range? So the range is the biggest data value minus the smallest data value, and it's pretty close. They both look like they're about 100. Box plot number 1 goes from 100 to 0, about 100. Box plot number 2 goes from 120 to 20, about 100. So they're almost the same, but if you really look closely, box plot number 1 from 100 to almost 0 should be in the upper 90s. Box plot number 2 going from 120 to a little lower than 20 would be a little more than 100. So the range is slightly bigger for box plot number 2. Not much. You really have to pay attention to the number scale. Which one has the largest interquartile range? Now again, your interquartile range will be Q3 minus Q1, the top edge of the box being Q3 and the lower edge of the box being Q1. So the larger interquartile range does definitely seem to be box plot number 1. And finally, part E, which one has the largest standard deviation? Now, this goes back to a previous section where the standard deviation is a measure of how spread out the data is. It was a measure of dispersion, how dispersed the data is. Where the majority of the values occur in a bigger range, like that middle chunk going from 60 to from 80 to 20 over 60 range, where this one most of the data values are crammed into a tighter spot, it would seem box plot number 1 has a bigger spread in its data and therefore a bigger standard deviation. So the one with the larger standard deviation would be box plot number 1.